said, thank you for joining us on another Sunday night. We always look forward to seeing you guys.
Yes, good evening, everybody. Good evening, Miss Q.
Hi, Jax.
How are you?
I'm good. And how are you?
I'm good. And we always talk about the weather, but I always have to say that I like it that it rains when it's not supposed to.
Okay.
I like it.
I'm not going to talk about the weather. I'm going to talk about Jekyll and Hyde, the repertory musical that's here. Please don't fail to catch it. And congratulations to the entire cast for a wonderful job.
Mm-hmm. You like one of the songs there, right?
Yes. Someone like
your
you.
Your favorite.
I love, love, love it.
Yeah, she was singing it in the dressing room when we were getting ready. And you have such a beautiful voice.
Well, you do too. Mutual admiration club we got here.
So speaking about talents. Okay.
Talent.
We have tonight, actually, a different kind. A person who is in the business where we are in.
Right.
And she is actually with her grandson.
Right.
Okay. Who is in the business that my family's in and you are in.
Yeah, so we can both relate. Mm-hmm. See, the great thing about this is we've had father and son.
Yes.
Right?
We've had brothers.
We've had brothers.
We haven't had sisters.
Not yet. Yes, we did. The sisters that sang.
Oh,
Christmas
special. Yeah, the sisters. Yeah. And yes.
But we haven't had a grandparent.
We had the Sarcada sisters.
Yeah.
No, we had your grandparents.
But not
a grandparent.
Yeah, with the guesting with the grandson.
The grandson or the granddaughter.
Yes, we had the grandparents. Big mom. Hi, happy 88th birthday.
Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Yeah,
yeah.
I know, right? She's so funny. We greet her twice because for many years she celebrated on a certain day, and then my big daddy found her birth certificate and found that it was 8 days later.
No, I think it was like that before. Yeah. Like even in the province, some people don't have birth certificates.
No proper records.
Yes.
Yeah.
So they celebrate twice.
Nice. We should have two birthdays.
Two presents.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We can choose our own.
Yes.
Yeah.
So about our guests, she said that for the grandson, she likes his watch.
Yeah, and I said it's really nice.
It's really nice. It's really nice to see them together.
Yes,
but that's
I like the relationship. Yeah,
mm-hmm.
They're obviously really close. Yes,
mm-hmm.
And she said about the eldest grandson that.
Well, we only have one grandson now.
Yeah,
and he's the eldest.
Yes, she said she likes looking at their relationship, they have
and
a
seeing
good
them
thing
together
going and seeing them together.
Wasn't
that
what you said?
Yeah, that's what you said. What did you say?
That's what I said.
That's what you said. But what I said was I like the relationship.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. And about the.
It's a good thing we're fighting. This is what Derek wants.
No. Yeah, fighting.
Yeah. Now we'll rate really high.
So about the grandmother, she said that. What did you say?
I said that it's obvious that she comes.
Okay. Yes. Okay. I know. She said that obvious that she comes from show business because she came here fully made up and she wore something colorful because tonight we are wearing just black and white.
Yeah, black and white.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we might as well be black and white and they won't notice. Yeah, it's really nice. I mean, she's obviously really prepared.
Yes.
And she said that she's interested to ask about how the lives of artistas were back then,
mm-hmm,
and what she does outside of it.
Yes.
Like
when they're not taping or shooting.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So they're probably wondering who we're talking about. Why are you giggling?
No, never mind. Okay. Okay.
Share. You have to share it with the audience.
No. I thought you meant them. What we were talking about. They, our guests.
Right.
But you meant our viewers.
Yes, I am.
But
yes.
So I know you're wondering, and you want to know who they are. So we will pause for a break. And she said, we'll be right back.
She said, if you're just joining us, we're just about to introduce our wonderful guests. It's quite intriguing because this lady was the first woman to ever don a swimsuit back in the days when she was an artista. Yeah.
Okay, and I want to know how that swimsuit looked.
For sure, one piece, no?
Yeah, one piece with shorts. Or with a skirt.
With matching ruffles sa likod,
diba? Or something. Diba? Yeah. Oh, let's ask. And then I wanna know what the top looked like. Like, was it low or was it...
Long sleeves, diba? Wetsuit pala. Wetsuit. Yeah.
But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, we are very fortunate to have with us a pair. One is a... One was... she was... a superstar during the 50s or 60s, 50s and 60s, and I'm sure...
Or maybe even back then, because that was in the 40s.
Yeah, started 40s and then 50s until the 60s.
Yes. Mm-hmm. But she's still in the industry
now.
Yes. Very much
and
so.
And she is also with her grandson, who is...
Vice Mayor.
The Vice Mayor of Parañaque, so we're going to meet them. So we have with us... So we should start with the man. Save the best for last.
Do it.
Best because she's a woman. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen.
And it's Women's Month.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, Women's Month all the time.
March, yeah.
So all the time.
Okay.
We still celebrate that every day.
Every day.
Mm-hmm. So ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to welcome to She Said, the Vice Mayor of Parañaque. We have Gus. Hello, Gus.
Hi, Jackie.
Hello.
Good evening.
Yes, good evening.
Hello.
Mm-hmm. So Gus Tambunting is the grandson.
The eldest.
Yeah, he's the eldest grandson of the superstar we have here, Miss Mila del Sol.
Good evening.
Yes. Hi, I'm Mila del Sol.
Yes.
And I'm 45.
Wow. She's our age.
Yes, yes. We're 45 already.
No, we will be five.
Yeah.
I like how the ring matches the bracelet, matches the terno, matches
and
the zapatillas.
I know. Was it like that before?
Well, we cannot afford to be ugly at this stage. Bawal sa amin ang pangit. Eh.
No, bawal naman sa lahat. No, so I would like to say, Miss Mila del Sol, she also founded, I'd like to say that I was in Tony and Guy having my hair and makeup done, and Miss Cutie was there too. And I told them who our guest was, okay? And Andy said, alam mo ba? Because he sees your name in the t-shirts of like maintenance people in Trinoma, where Tony and Guy is, one of the branches of Tony and Guy is. So I'd like to know that Mila del Sol, that's you?
Yes.
That's your company?
Yes, yes.
Oh,
founded by my
cleaning services
with me by my oldest son, the father of the Vice Mayor, mm-hmm. Sunny Tambunting.
And how did you start that while you were in show business? Of course, you're still in show business. So how did that start?
Well, it was really through the urging of my oldest son, Sunny, mm-hmm. because he grew up in the States, and while there, he was working all the time. You know, that panahon. Walang drugs, walang mga kalokohan, no? Everybody was working even at a certain age. Ang kasama niya sa pagja-janitors America, si Ricky Nelson, anak ni Bing Crosby. So he was in good company. So when we came here for a vacation, he wanted to work. And he wanted to do something. So I called some friends, and they told me because of his age, he was only 17 or 18. He said, he's too young, we cannot accept him. So my son insisted on forming up a janitorial service. And of course, I resented. I said, no, movie star ako, mag-janitor ako. But then he insisted. So, and then that also gave us a chance to give employment to thousands of jobless people and to keep thousands of homeless children off the street and give them food, security, and education mm-hmm. through the help of my grandson.
Yes, well, that's nice to know because there are many superstars of way back, and when they feature their lives now, it's very different from what they were before. Like the others, they never really saved whatever they made. And there was actually even one, she was working for one of her like manicuristas or something. So she's now working for that manicurista.
So actually, a lot of them, when like in their old age, they're asking for help for medical expenses and all that. But a few of them were able to invest, like Tita Amalia Fuentes,
yes,
and obviously Tita Mila here. Mm-hmm. How many people do you think you have on your workforce?
More or less 10,000.
Yeah. 10,000?
Well, not only here and also abroad.
Oh, okay. So this is, I see. Do you have many in the provinces also?
Yes.
What countries are you offering janitorial
California
services?
California. Right.
So who's the one who manages it in California?
We have other managers. There are some relatives and some trained here in the Philippines to work over there.
Do you think having your name as the owner helped with people getting your services, or did it push it, or do you think that there was an advantage or disadvantage to this?
Yeah, apparently yes, it's the name recall. Because sometimes when they have to choose between what services they would take, they would think of me first because of
they remember your name.
Name. And it really helped a lot having been in the movies, and I'm very grateful for that. So I'm just giving advice to these movie stars now, no? Gamitin ninyo ang inyong magandang pangalan for the good of others, because you can help many, many people because of your good name.
Yeah, see, I mean, imagine 10,000 people employed now, so 10,000 lives automatically changed.
Yes.
And, you know, it's funny how she just said her advice was to use your name in a good way, and already we see it in her first grandson, who is a public servant.
Yes.
So there, you know, there's a
connection there. So are you involved in the business?
Yes, I am. I'm the president and the chief operating officer of the company, and I've been at it for 16 years now.
Mm-hmm.
But I really grew up in the business. I was trained as a janitor during my elementary days. This is a company that's been around for 47 years.
Oh, wow.
I was only 1 year old when my father and my grandmother started this. So I watched them grow the business, and I just grew it further when I took over.
What kind of training? Like, what did they make you do?
Well, I was asked to clean bathrooms and offices during my elementary days. My summers were spent not in the beach, but cleaning offices and buildings.
Did you get paid
Bureau
for
of
that?
Immigration. Yes, I was paid for that. And I was even cleaning the office of my principal. I'm a graduate of Letran College, and that was one of our clients then. Even the Bureau of Immigration then was a client. And I used to clean the office of the commissioner every summer. All my 5 summers during elementary, from grade 4 all the way to third year high school, was spent cleaning offices.
Well, it's summer, and would it be nice? It would be nice to have a vice mayor clean our house.
No, what?
Sure. I'll give you my number
special.
After the show.
No, we can't afford you.
But
let's talk about the price later.
Cleaning the work area of a person says a lot about the person who works in that area.
Yes. And definitely discipline kicked in. And I always had my feet on the ground, even though I was the son of the owner. It was different. And even for the clients, it made a difference when they see the grandson of Mila del Sol cleaning their office.
That's
malaking bagay sa kanila.
So do you wear a T-shirt that says, I'm the grandson of Mila?
No, I don't.
No,
but I wear the ordinary uniform, and I learned to eat and breathe with the janitors. That's why entering politics at a very young age, at 23, this was after martial law. I was the youngest councillor in the city of Parañaque.
How old were you then?
23 years old.
23.
And it was easy for me to relate to the people, to the masa, because I grew up with janitors.
Mm-hmm, but good for you. It's good that you were, you're the son of the owner, and you were taught to work like that. Because my father's like that. You know, he's not just going to give us money. Like, you have to work. I was upholstering chairs for fiberglass.
Really?
And I was getting an allowance, and I was a student. See, so you have to start and learn. And since you were going to manage it, then you would have to really know how the rank and file.
Yeah, I think my dad at that early age knew that he wanted me to take over. So he had to really train. And swerte naman, ako naman, I like to work.
But
I always was into business. I was always selling something.
Okay,
so
but what about working janitorial services? Did you like that? Did you resent it?
No, I enjoyed it because at a very young age, that meant additional allowance for me. The savings I would generate in 2 months for
summer. How much
did
you get then?
I think 8 pesos a day.
Eight pesos a day. What year was this?
This was in 1974.
And what did you do with the money?
Saved it.
For?
For
toys?
I would save it for
beach.
No. I would basically save it so that I had more allowance during school year.
You know, I recently came across an article of Susie Armand, she's a really good like financial advisor, where she says children shouldn't get allowance.
Yes, it I have changed that in my house.
Yeah,
yes.
So you saw that. She was saying something like the children should do chores and then get money for it, so that way they don't feel entitled.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So we're going to pause for a quick break. When we come back, I want to ask Vice Mayor, how was it growing up being the grandson of a famous actress? Right here on She Said, She Said.
She said, and if you're just joining us, we are still with a tandem grandson and superstar. We have Miss Mila Del Sol, the superstar of the 40s, 50s, and 60s, and she is with her grandson, who's a vice mayor of Paranaque, Gus Tambunting. So we were talking about giving allowance, giving a little salary instead of allowance. So I have told my children that they would have to do house chores, like bringing out their plates and, you know, folding their blankets after sleeping, and maybe doing a little washing. I mean, yeah, washing the dishes, whatever is not very, breakable. And then they can also clean a little and then fix up. And they're so excited. So the little ones say, oh, I want to do that. I want to start. So, and then she said, why are you telling this to me? Why did you change it? Because Mama said, because my mom saw the show.
Mm-hmm. Oh, she saw that show. Yeah. I love that show.
Yes, and she's very good.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Actually, I follow her because she's
really?
Always on Oprah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, have you saved?
I've always saved.
Really?
I'm good at saving.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Show.
So, I want to ask Vice Mayor, how was it growing up being the grandson, especially because you were the
eldest? Somebody so famous.
Yeah.
Well, every time I was asked, and people would know that I was the eldest grandson of Mila Del Sol. The first reaction is, huh? Because, you know, she's very, very pretty, and I wasn't a very handsome.
And you're not
student.
So pretty.
And, you know, my teachers were surprised. They always thought I was joking. And, you know, I would say I'm the grandson of Mila Del Sol. But indeed, it opened doors for me.
Mm-hmm. In what way?
In the business, even as a public servant. Every time I would run for public office, and that was 4 elections as councillor, the number one councillor of the city, and two terms as vice mayor, I would always say in my speech that I was the eldest grandson of Mila Del Sol.
Did she campaign for you?
On the last two, as vice mayor, she did, because she wasn't here in the 4 terms as councillor, but I would put her in my flyers, and I would tell people that I'm the grandson, especially pagdating sa senior citizen. You know, I would say I'm the nephew of John Young, but you know, that was a different era
Are you
altogether.
The nephew of John Young.
Yes, John is the daughter of Mila Del Sol.
Oh,
and
I never knew that.
Okay.
Okay, and that was the reaction. You would see that there's a difference in the reaction. Pagdating sa senior citizen, more people remember Mila Del Sol than John Young, especially even the youth. Maybe because also of the cleaning business, and they get to see her movies pa rin on TV.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But she's still guesting now.
Yes.
She has teleseries,
yes, but
right?
But not like Tita Bani or John. She seldom had movies. That's why you don't see her anymore. Mm-hmm. After Spin a Win, wala na.
Where is she now?
Spin a Win,
New York.
Yeah. She has renounced all the fame and glamour of showbiz. And she's living now in a convent in New York.
A convent?
As
yes,
what?
You are
care
kidding me.
Of orphans and sick nuns.
But that is so admirable.
How beautiful.
Yeah, but in the afternoon, she goes to the University of New York to pursue her legal studies.
Oh, so she's still in school as well?
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. That's amazing.
It's so nice to know that.
And the next time she's in town, we should guest her.
Here?
Yeah, the next time she comes to town.
Mm-hmm. No.
When yes, we will. We'll ask the Joey. We'll talk to the Joey when she's in town.
So, Tita Mila, we wanted to know, how was it being an actress back then? Is it any different from, because you're still working now, you see how actresses behave, how they dress, and what their work ethics are. Was it any different compared to when you were working in the 40s, 50s, and 60s?
Well, yes and no. Because now I find some of the young actors and actresses are really good actors and actresses. During our time, there was no school for learning how to act like that. But now they have, and they're doing very well. I just made Rosalka last year, and the leading girl is very good. I think her name, what's her name? Sorry, I forget, yeah, no? Sorry. But then also the men were the son of Bembo Rocco, the son of Lito Lapid, almost the sons of the stars mm-hmm. of my time. And they're very hardworking. I'm surprised that they're very respectful, because there was a time, a transition, that's why I got out of the movies. When the movie stars would delay the shooting for 2, 3, or even 10 hours because she broke up with her boyfriend,
like
or
who?
She has stomach ache.
Like who, Tita Mira? Like who? Like back then, who did that?
Yeah.
Who was the girl who broke up with her boyfriend and he didn't go to taping?
That what?
Who are the stars who delayed your shooting and taping
for 10
because
hours.
They broke up with their boyfriend? Tell us the name of the star, and then you can tell us the name of the boyfriend as well.
No comments.
You can tell us at the break, and we will tell you also after.
Yeah, I'll put it in our she said page on Facebook.
But Tita, I heard that stars weren't really allowed to go out. Like, if they didn't have work, they wouldn't really go out to where their malls at that time. They didn't go out to make pasyal, you know, or they would have to be really made up and dressed.
Yes. Yes.
Because I go out like with no makeup at all and wear shorts and
diba ginagawang bahay anything close to you.
So that
yes, we really dress up to meet the public because the public pays so much and they give us so much love and affection to keep us there. So we have to show our best also. We don't go out like not dress well, miniskirts and all that, no. During my time, anyway, we were always very conservative.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And so, okay, speaking of conservative, which brings me to my next question. For what did you do the bathing suit scene? Was it for a movie or for pictorials? And your grandson, Vice Mayor, was just telling us that it was quite controversial. How did you handle all that?
Will you answer that for me?
No, were you asked?
You can answer what pictorial, and she can answer the feeling.
That was a scene in one of her films where she was asked to take off her dress.
Yeah.
But you know, it was really a bathing suit. It's like a sarong belt.
Yeah.
So inside the dress,
but you see more skin on.
Yeah.
Okay. Inside the dress, you were wearing a sarong.
Yes.
Inside the dress.
Yes, inside the dress, and she took it off. Then she had to dye. In
to
a
the
river,
pool? A river.
Pero naka-sarong siya, but there was really so much skin from.
Why? Because the sarong had a big slit?
Yes. No, it was actually the sarong short? Was kind of short.
A short sarong.
Yes.
Half a sarong.
Okay, so a sarong meaning something that you tie here?
Yes, yes.
There was a time I was called the original sarong girl, like Dorothy Lamour. Oh, you wouldn't remember Dorothy Lamour, but she was a beautiful actress and Hollywood actress that wears only sarong like that.
I can't imagine how a sarong would look like because our version of sarongs, if you tie here, comes all the way down to the ankle, right? Or the short
could
sarong.
Could be long or short.
Yeah.
Could
okay,
be
so when you...
But does it open?
Yeah, it opens. There's nothing inside. And you dove?
Yes.
You dove inside the pool. But
wearing
then
under?
The sarong would go up.
Yeah, because it goes this way.
Well,
what about you had an underwear?
Siguro, yeah.
Siguro. She doesn't remember.
Oh, no.
Siguro, wala.
Siguro, wala.
Anyway, hindi naman kita kasi underwater. Pero noon, malinis ang water.
Aww.
So, kita.
But now, hindi na makita. Back then, if that was, they say it was quite controversial, what made you decide to go ahead and do this, or did you have an internal conflict? Did you have to discuss it with your
parents, or your boyfriend?
No, walang manager sa amin noon.
Were you handled by Vera Paris?
We're just picked up by the movie producers.
But who would they speak to, like, with regard to your talent fees and your schedules? Mm. Just straight?
To our parents.
Parents. It was always parents back then.
Parents namin, ng aming pinaka-manager, guardian, and everything.
And your parents agreed right away that you do the sarong bathing suit scene?
After some...
Prodding.
or never.
So at first they didn't want. Mm-mm. What were their reservations back then? Why didn't they want you to do the bathing suit scene?
There really wasn't much, you know, because depend upon the situation. If you have to wear sarong, then we must wear sarong. You cannot be in long gown or dressy gown if the scene calls for a sarong. And that was the thing of the time, you know, wearing sarong, showing just a little bit skin here, a little skin there. Mm-hmm. Just a little skin everywhere.
Your parents weren't from show business.
Oh, very conservative.
Oh no.
Very conservative, Jackson. You know what? I really want to ask more about this sarong and the swimsuit scene. So we're going to pause for just a little bit, but we're coming right back with more of the sarong stories from the 40s, right here on She Said, She Said. She said we are still with Miss Mila Del Sol, the superstar of the 40s, 50s, and 60s, and her grandson, Vice Mayor Gus Tambunting. So we were talking about during the break, okay, you were saying that she was the first actress when she was 13. Okay,
yes.
If your parents were very conservative, how did that happen? I mean, how did you get into showbiz? Somebody saw you? Did they talk to your parents? Did you... Did you apply?
The first big star in the family was my older sister, Gloria Imperial, who became Mrs. Alfredo Buñi, who is the mother of Toting Buñi, the presidential secretary.
Okay. Yes.
And then when they were forming LVN, they thought of getting my sister. But her fiancé, then Mr. Buñi, did not want her to work in the films anymore because they were getting married. And then Bading Dilim.
Yes.
How old was she then? Was she like 16, 18?
About 17, 18.
Wow. What?
Yeah, they
got married at the time.
Yeah, that age. They married early then.
So they saw you.
Yeah.
This is like Cinderella.
Bading Dilim, the daughter of Doña Sisang, remembered the sabi nila, may kapatid dyan, batang-bata nga lang at saka mataba. I was really fat. But let's try her. So over the, against the wishes of the director, who was very big than Carlos van der Tolosa, when Doña Sisang saw me, it was really love at first sight. She liked me right away, and I love her, you know. Mm-hmm. So she told the director and everybody, okay, I want Mila, my real name is really Clarita Rivera. And they called me Mila, because the Mila in the movies, the lead in the movie is called Mila.
Mm-hmm.
So I said, okay, I want Mila in that movie. And the director Tolo said, no, she's too young. She cannot do this, she cannot do that. She can't even make a love scene. How do you expect her to do a love scene? She's only 13. So just follow her around, see what she's doing, and tell me. Because they're always making sumbong to Doña Sisang, you know.